Good evening and welcome to our fall concert, our fall choral showcase, that is. We're thrilled that you're here this evening to support all the hard work that these students have put in at the beginning part of the semester. I want to mention that although there isn't an official intermission, there are some stage changes between each choir that will take a few minutes, so feel free to say hi to the neighbor next to you, meet someone new, and then we'll get started with the next group. We think you're in for quite the treat tonight, a huge variety of music, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the rest of the concert.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. And that was the set of four songs, opus number 92 by Johannes Brahms. Brahms being one of my favorite composers. He's from the Romantic period. Although we don't have a title for this particular portion of the concert, I can say it is music of Romantic period or Romantic era, meaning that he's a composer from the 19th century. He was born in 1897. Our next piece is by a composer named Hugo Wolf. He's also from the Romantic period. As you heard, there's a beautiful melody from Brahms, but the next piece, the Feuerreiter, is quite different, although he comes from the 19th century Romantic period. I asked the staff to get a little bit more lighting in the house so that you can read the translations of this poetry. The Feuerreiter, and this Fire Rider, it's based on this mythical character named the Fire Rider. I hope you have a chance to read the translation so you understand what's going on in the story. It's a very, very dramatic story. It's about a fire rider who mysteriously appears anytime there's a fire and wearing a red cap and riding on a galloping horse, arriving at the scene. And after the entire fiasco of the big fire, at the end of the story, the fire rider is no longer seen. Only the red cap that he was wearing can be found. So Hugo Wolf kind of lived at the end of the Romantic period, so you'll be able to hear the very dramatic and very expressive writing that has a lot of chromaticism and somewhat much more dissonant than what you heard from Brahms. You can definitely hear that by the end of this century, or is the beginning of the 20th century, that composers were trying to break away from what's considered a tonality. Tonality is what you hear in music, very consonant. So you hear some very aggressive harmonic progression, but yet still, it's very tonal. So we finish with a D major triad. So this is the Feuerreiter by Hugo Wolf.
Thank you.
That was pretty intense music, I just think. Yeah. Our next piece is completely the opposite of what we sang and how we are saying it. So next piece is called A Serenade to Music by Vaughan Williams. Vaughan Williams, although he's from 20th century, and he lived through the first part of the 20th century, he's often considered as a romantic composer or neo-romantic, meaning that kind of harkening back to what the composers from the romantic period, 19th century, did. So if you hear this music, you'll hear very lush and beautiful harmony and really singable melody. And this piece was originally written for 16 soloists. And in the score, it says, it indicates who sang which part. But it can be done with a choir, it can be done with by 16 soloists or 4 soloists. But in tonight's performance, we're going to have 7 soloists coming from the choir, and still will be a alternation between entire choir singing something, and sometimes we'll have each soloist sing. This was written for the orchestra, but tonight we have a piano and then the violin soloist, who is going to be accompanying our chamber choir for this evening's performance. So I would like to invite our guest violinist, Dr. Manfredi, on the stage, and I hope you enjoy this wonderful piece by Vaughan Williams, Serenade to Music.
Thank you.
So we have one more song for you with everybody on the stage. So I'm going to ask everybody, wherever you are, probably from the backstage or in the audience, so I'm going to invite everybody come back to stage. And while we're going to try to fit 200 people on the stage, I'd like to thank you one more time to come and support our first concert of the year. And I'm really, really excited and also thrilled to have Nathan Pan, the conductor of the concert choir and University Chorus, to return this year, and also not only to remain as a conductor of the University Chorus, but also to take on the responsibility of conducting the concert choir this year. So I'm thrilled, and I'm really proud of my, as a former teacher now, as a colleague and a friend, I think you, if you have your children in our core program, I assure you that they're getting a wonderful experience and they're learning a ton every single day, every single rehearsal. So now it is our final number, the cornerstone. I hope we have everybody here on the stage. And Nathan is going to be conducting from there, not on the stage, right? So again, once again, thank you so much for coming to our concert.
The cornerstone of a whole new world, the
Thank you so much for coming. Have a great evening, drive safe, and have fun.